We want to determine the intercepts of the line given the equation of the line, which means we want to determine the x-intercept and the y-intercept of the line. Well, the x-intercept is where the line crosses the horizontal axis here, and the y-intercept is where the line crosses the vertical axis, or this axis here. Notice that every point along the x-axis has a y-coordinate of 0, and every point along the y-axis has an x-coordinate equal to 0. And from this information, we can determine the x and y intercepts. It really comes down to completing a special t-table or table of values. In order to determine the x-intercept, we set y equal to 0 and solve for x. And in order to determine the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. So by completing this special t-table or table of values, we can determine the x and y intercepts. Let's start by determining the x-intercept. So we're going to set y equal to 0 and solve for x. Notice if we set y equal to 0, this term here is going to be 0. I'll go ahead and show that this first time. We'd have 2x minus 3 times 0 equals 12. But again, notice this term is equal to 0, so we're just left with 2x equals 12. So if we divide both sides by 2, we have x equals 6. So when y is equal to 0, x is equal to 6, which means the x-intercept is the point 6, 0. Now it is important that we don't just say x equals 6, because remember, x equals 6 is an equation of a vertical line, and the x-intercept is a point. Now to determine the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0 and solve for y. And again, notice that if x is equal to 0, 2x would be 0. But again, I'll go ahead and write it out this time. But 2 times 0 is 0, so we're left with the one-step equation, negative 3y equals 12. So we can divide both sides by negative 3. And we have y equals negative 4, which means when x is equal to 0, y is equal to negative 4. Therefore, the y-intercept is the point 0, negative 4. And this is enough information to graph the line. The x-intercept is the point 6, 0, or this point here. The y-intercept is the point 0, negative 4, this point here. Therefore, our line passes through these two points. So when a linear equation is in standard form, or this form here, determining the x and y intercepts is often a great way to graph the line. And it really comes down to completing a special t-table where we let y equal to 0 to determine the x-intercept, and then let x equal 0 to determine the y-intercept. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.